Hello everyone and welcome to video tutorial brought to you by MATLAB helper. Today we are going to see Gauss-Seidel method. The Gauss-Seidel method is the most commonly used iterative method for solving linear algebraic equations. Assume that we are given a set of n equations. That is A of x is equal to b, where A is matrix, x1, x2 and x3 are variable for which we are going to solve the equations. Now for time being, we are going to limit ourselves to a 3x3 set of equations for consciousness. Now consider this figure. It shows two methods, that is Gauss-Seidel method and Jacobi iterative method. The first variable x1 is given by b1 minus a12x2 minus a13x3 upon first diagonal element of matrix A, that is a11. Since x1 represents first row, we are going to cover every element of first row of n by n matrix except for its diagonal element. Since we are considering 3x3 matrix, we are going to cover first row second column, that is a12, and a13, that is first row third column element. Now for second variable, that is x2, we are going to put first variable x1 in the second place, which will give us the equation b2 minus a21x1 minus a23x3 divided by diagonal element of second row, that is a22. We are going to repeat the same condition for third row variable, that is x3, wherein the upper variable, that is x2, is going to be in the third place, that is along with a32, that is third row second column element. Now since we have three variables x1, x2, x3, after three iterations we are going to go to the second loop of second iteration. We are going to repeat the same procedure here. Now let's see the code. We have written a function here, a Gauss-Seidel, which usually takes four arguments, that is A, B, E, S and max IT, where A is coefficient matrix, B is right hand side vector, ES is stop criteria whose default value is set to 0.00001%, and max IT denotes maximum iteration whose default value is set to 50, and we are going to get output as x, where x is solution vector. Now in further procedure, we are going to check if arguments are less than 2. If they are less than 2, we are going to show an error message, that is at least 2 input arguments required. The further step denotes if arguments are less than 4, that means only if 3 arguments are provided without max iteration, then by default max iteration is going to get to set 50. Similarly, for arguments less than 3, these 2 arguments are going to be in there without the third argument ES, which is our stop criteria. And if not, we are going to set it as 0.00001%. Now we are going to provide input A whose size is m, n, where m is number of rows and n is number of columns. Now since we have established that we are going to need a square matrix where m is equal to n, we are going to check if m and n are equal in the input vector A, and if not, we are going to show error message, that is matrix A must be a square. Further, we are assigning matrix A to temporary matrix C. Now moving on, these two for loops are performing iterative operations as we have discussed earlier, with first element divided by its diagonal element, that is either a11, a1, a22 or a33. After that, we are going to set iteration count to 0 again, so as to move to further procedure of running sum. Now in while one loop, we are continuously updating x value to the value obtained from this operation, which is basically a running sum operation to update the stop criteria of our operations. And after each circulation, we are going to increase the iteration count. This condition checks if the newly updated value of stop criteria is less than or equal to previously set value, and iteration count is greater than or equal to max iteration count, that is default 50 value, And if so, we are going to break and we are going to print the output on the display screen. Now let's run the program. For that, we would be needing matrix A, which is a square matrix. Another thing would be next argument B, which is right hand side square vector. Let's input the arguments. We would get the answer x1 as 3, x2 as -2.5, and x3 as 7. So you can try with different values of A and B to run this code. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any queries, any questions, you can post it in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching the video.